Hello, Key Master here. Today I want to pick this huge book, Vector Alpha Titan 900. This is a massive lock and the biggest from the Book Vector brand. Compared here to the Book Vector Alpha 800, so you can see this is really huge. Or maybe you are more familiar with an American lock 1100. As you can see, this is really tiny compared to this beast. And as you can see here, it's a high-tech security padlock with removable cylinder system for European standard and Scandinavian oval cylinder. So you buy only the body and put a cylinder inside it, and the body costs about 130 to 150 euros. But I got this from eBay, way cheaper, and it already had a Euro cylinder inside the body. And this lock I now want to pick. I've already picked it, and I have to say this is a really cheap Euro cylinder, and I will replace it with a much better cylinder, that's for sure. This is a shame to put such a lock inside this huge body. But first, I want to pick it. So I put the lock into the vise. It's much easier to pick that way because it's so heavy. But this lock shouldn't be a problem at all. I use top of the keyway tensioning. Maybe I change the lighting a little bit. So, and this is an SS dev hook in 15,000. And I cast a shadow with my thumb. Five. Three is loose, two is loose, one is loose. Maybe I've overset pin 5, I'm not sure. There was a click from 3. One is loose, two is loose. Do something wrong. I start from the front now. One is loose, two is loose, three. There was a click from 3. Another one. Yeah. Four and five are loose. One is loose. Maybe I've not set 3. Four. One is still loose, two is loose. Ah,
there was a nice click from three. I think now, yeah, three feels set now. And now one is binding. And I have a nice false set. So now two is binding. Yeah, definitely two is binding. And there's counter rotation. Now I have to be careful. Yeah, counter rotation. And open. Yes. So now let's look inside. I have not gutted it yet. So let's see. This is not so easy to gut. I read the description. As you can see, it's open, of course. First, you can see here is a cap. I have to remove this cap. And now I need a screwdriver. Let's see. Yeah, this works. So and now I have to remove this screw here. Okay. So sure, can I remove it already? Ah, yes, I have to remove this one here. Wow. So interesting. So you can see here. Here's a Euro profile cylinder. This is good here. This looks like plastic, but it's also steel. It's quite heavy. So now we can see which model this Euro cylinder is. It's an ECV, FCV. Never heard of it. Interesting. So, maybe I use this. Ah, come on, focus. I lock it up, I have the key. And let's see what kind of circlip is there. Oh no, this looks bad. Oh, come on. I lost the patience, I had to brute force into this stupid cheap lock. As you can see here, the circlip is not bendable. And that's why it's what's possible for me to remove it. I hate it. Unbelievable. Finally. Can't believe it. Ah, no. So let's see, I expect there are only standard pins, standard key pins. That's right, and there's at least one spool. That's for sure. There was counter rotation at pin 2. So let's see. Standard pin 1. Spool in 2. Standard in 3. Spool in 4. And standard in 5. So really nothing special here as expected, and of course I don't don't want to use such a scrap lock in this awesome lock body. I have here another one that I put into this lock. This is a Dome RS8, and it has 8 pins. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And where are the other 3? Here, on this side. Here are 3 more pins. Pretty awesome lock. So, yeah, this was a Burgwächter Alpha Titan 900. Thank you for watching and have a nice day. Bye.